God be with you. Jesus, one of y'all ought to check that out. Where in Christ's name did you go? Better go see where he got to. Huh?
What do you think, Chuck?
What? Huh?
Shit. What the hell happened?
On it.
Huh?
thinking about Thomas Lee after my old man.
It's got a nice ring to it.
This shit with us getting hit doesn't get settled. My boy might wind up being named something else.
Nah, it won't come to that. The boys will take care of it, you see.
I'll hunt this animal down.
You can die with these Dixie assholes, or work for me and live.
Okay, sure thing. Whatever you want.
You work for me now. Send your men to the First Baptist Church. Those Dixie heathens have been handled.
I'll have some of my men come right over. And thanks.
State your name for the record.
Donovan. John.
Mr. Donovan, you understand that by appearing before this committee, you have explicitly waived your constitutional rights in regards to counsel and self-incrimination.
Sure.
And you further acknowledge that by appearing before this committee, you agree to disclose all information pertaining to the events that occurred in New Bordeaux during the summer and fall of 1968.
I wouldn't be sitting here if I didn't.
You were an operative in the Central Intelligence Agency from 1953 to 1969, is that correct?
That's right.
When did you arrive in Vietnam?
August of 1961.
Please describe for this committee the actions you took during your time in Vietnam.
I spent a couple months in Saigon. Then I was transferred to a base in Laos that was operated by the Special Activities Division. We trained and equipped the Hmong and then turned them loose on the NVA. We're running arms and supplies via the Ho Chi Minh Trail.
And you worked with Lincoln Clay in what eventually became the Phoenix Program.
Within a year or so, Lincoln was heading up his own PRU. We'd cross over into Vietnam and locate enemy targets and either kill them or bring them back for interrogation. Just thinking about it? Jesus Christ. You wouldn't believe the shit we did to those cocksuckers.
God ain't forgetting what those motherfuckers did to this place, Mr. Clay. I won't teaser.
Thank you. This man's name is Jesse. We were just having ourselves a little conversation about Richie Doucet.
Listen, I ain't done nothing, you hear? I don't know anything. I was just taking a walk and walking down the street and she grabbed me is all.
You a Dixie Mafia?
No. Yes. I mean, shit. I did it for the money, you hear? I ain't got nothing personal against y'all. I don't even carry a gun.
Where's Doucet?
He's out at the abandoned amusement park to the west of here.
Banned Saturdays? What the hell is he doing out there?
From what I heard, it's because you've been tearing things up. Georgie's on a goddamn warpath. He wants Richie dead. So Richie, he grabbed what was left of the heroin and took off. Said he was gonna lay low until he could settle things with Georgie.
How many men he got with him?
Hell, I don't know. All of them.
Hand me that knife.
No, no, please. No, I ain't done nothing to y'all. Please, I'm begging you. My mama, my papa, shit.
Go on, get.
He could warn Doucet.
He ain't no threat to nobody. Let him run back home to his mama.
If you wrong, there'll be hell to pay.
I'm running low. Can you send supplies to Delray Hollow?
Be out directly.
You want something? You let me know.
Show me what you got.
I got a bad sense about this, man. Richie needs to work this shit out with Georgie.
Well, he ain't got no fucking choice. Because if he don't,
We fucked like your mama on prom night.
For sure, man. For sure. Well, better get back to it before Bobby starts hollering again.
All right, then. Watch your ass down there.
He's taking us out!
You're dead, cocksucker!
Virgil led him back. form of a young priest, Father Michael. The Lord called Father Michael to take his dead body and gone astray.
This dude, boy. You think you can come in here and steal my heroin without nobody noticing?
I'm not here to steal your heroin, Richie. I'm here to make you pay for what you did to Sammy and Ellis Robinson.
I didn't have nothing to do with it!
I watched you stab Ellis in the gut. I couldn't do nothing about it then, but I sure as hell can now.
God damn it. None of that was my idea, you hear? It was all Georgie, him and his old man. They wanted y'all gone, not me. What was I supposed to do, say no?
Either that or make sure that I was dead.
Oh, no, no, no. No, please, please, listen, listen. Just decent thing would be to let a man get in a prayer before you kill him.
You can pray on the way up.
When I saw Richie Doucette hanging from that Ferris wheel, I felt a profound sense of disbelief. Nothing like this had ever happened before. The mobsters killed each other all the time, but it was generally a small, contained event. Some greaseball is eating spaghetti and meatballs at his favorite restaurant and gets popped in the head. But this was different. Even then, even before I knew who killed him, I knew that Richie had been put on display. Lincoln was trained in psychological warfare by the CIA. He wanted to terrify the mob, wanted them to know he was going to kill every last one of them, and that none of them would be able to stop him.